starting right now. Here's your host Alfredo Leon.
Thank God, Denny Hamlin overcame two penalties on pit road and won the NASCAR Cup race at Texas Motor Speedway, where Kyle Busch missed out on the chance for a triple-header weekend sweep, and pole sitter Jimmy Johnson's career worst winless streak stretched to 66 races. Hamlin led the final 12 laps and 45 laps of the 334 overall at the 1.5-mile track Sunday. Also won the Daytona 500 in his number 11 Joe Gibbs Racing Toyota. It was Hamlin's third win at Texas and his first since sweeping both races in 2010. Here is Hamlin speaking on the win and how his car was, and more courtesy of Fox.
Yeah, our car was really, really fast. We obviously saw that. Once we got out front, we were actually able to pull away from the pack a little bit. So just got a little bit loose right there when we were racing our teammates with the 18 and the 20. So I wasn't able to be as aggressive as I was earlier in the race, but we had a super fast car, and that's why we won. I missed pit road under green. That cost us 3 or 4 seconds as well. So I don't know. We tried every way we could to give it away, and just we found a way to do it with this FedEx Camry.
Gibbs drivers have won 4 of the 7 races this season, and Team Penske won the other 3. Clint Bowyer finished 2nd, followed by Daniel Suarez, Eric Jones, and Johnson. Johnson, whose last win was at Dover in June 2017, led 61 laps. Here's Johnson speaking of what it's like to be back in front of the pack and more, also courtesy of Fox Sports.
Yeah, it's great to be back in the mix. It's where this team deserves to be, and our sponsors with Ally and Chevy, everybody on board, especially, I guess, to add to that, just the hard, all the work that goes into getting these cars to the track and the changes we continue to make. So I hope everybody at Hendrick Motorsports is smiling big right now. We still have more work to do, but to have all 4 cars with such pace, I think 2 or 3 of us had great results. It's just a big step in the right direction for us.
After Johnson, here's the rest of the top 10. His teammate William Byron finishing 6th, driving a 24 car for Hendrick Motorsports. Eric Almirola finishing 7th, driving a 10 car for Stewart Haas Racing. His teammate Kevin Harvick finishing 8th in the 4 car. And Kurt Busch finishing 9th in the 1 car for Chicken Assy Racing. And right out the top 10 was Kyle Busch's brother, finishing 10th after leading 6 times for a race high 66 laps before brushing the wall. The next Cup Series race will be the Food City 500 at Bristol Motor Speedway in Bristol, Tennessee on Sunday, April 7th at 2 p.m. with coverage beginning there on Fox. What a win for Denny Hamlin, as it took him 2 speeding penalties to win the race. Incredible. Usually you don't overcome, usually if you get a speeding penalty, you don't win the race, but usually you can only have 1 of them in order to try to come back and win. But Hamlin had 2. Incredible that he was still able to win the race despite 2 penalties. That doesn't happen very often, and he was definitely fortunate to get a win like that. But tells you how well he's been doing this year already. 2 wins after winning none all last year. He could be one of the favorites to win the championship. I mean, Toyota is definitely one of the more dominant teams, especially with Kyle Busch winning a lot of races, and now Hamlin's got 2. Incredible, and it goes to show you like how incredible like it is so far this year, bouncing back and everything like that. And definitely fortunate for him to be able to get 2 wins this year. I mean, the Daytona 500, a big win there. Not taking anything away from it, but nice for him to now get another win and definitely try to position himself more in the chase to get himself more bonus points and more stage points to get himself higher in the standings. So it goes to show you how incredible he is. And in fact, 2 speeding penalties and still come back to win. That's incredible. That's impressive. And look out for Hamlin to be a potential favorite to win a championship this year. So we'll see if he can keep it going. But as far as Johnson's concerned, good for him to get a top 5. I mean, he led more laps in that race at Texas for more than all of last year combined, and even this year too. I mean, it tells you that Johnson is definitely going in the right direction, and hopefully it's a good sign for Hendrick Motorsports, because they've struggled with the Camaro. If they've only won 3 races, the only driver who has won in the Camaro for Hendrick has been Chase Elliott, who won 3 races last year. He hasn't yet won this year, so, but good for Jimmy to be able to get a top 5, and let's see if he can keep it going. I mean, this is definitely a good sign for him, especially hopefully that he can keep it going. And if he keeps doing it like this, who knows? He could win another race. I think he'll win another one maybe this year. We'll see. But maybe he can position up for another championship too. And this is a good sign, especially him getting comfortable with the Camaro. And let's see if he can keep that going as well, because he's too good to have this long of a winning streak, and I think he'll by the way, to victory lane. If he keeps this up, I mean, he's already got a top five, and he led laps, too, so that's a good sign. If he keeps being fast in practice and qualifying well, he's got a shot at winning races. He just needs to have a fast enough car and not put himself and make a lot of mistakes on pit road. Like he said, many times, like, he's made a lot of mistakes on pit road, and he's got to clean that up, and definitely this race, he cleaned that up for sure, and if he can keep cleaning up those mistakes, he'll definitely have a chance to win races, and that's definitely good for the sport to see him back on top, and especially with all the struggles he's had the last year plus. So this is definitely a good step in the right direction for Engine Motorsports. I mean, the only guy who wasn't in the top 10 was Chase Elliott, but William Byron up there, well, also Alex Bowman, but I mean, you definitely expect Hendrick to definitely get more better as the season goes along, and this is definitely a good step in the right direction for Jimmy. So let's see if he can keep that going, and definitely a nice moment for him, like I said, to come back from two penalties. That's incredible. I mean, to be able to do that, that creates excitement too. I mean, to see if he could come back twice, and he did. And like I said, that usually doesn't happen. And usually winning penalties are usually costly, but two of them, it's incredible that he still found a way to win. And it's still, that's a nice moment for him to get that win. And got some momentum going into Bristol, which should be a nice race as well on the short track. Now, that'll cause some tempers. Usually does, so somewhat. And that should be exciting there as well. And see if he can keep it going. Like I said, Jimmy Johnson, could he keep it going as well? Get moving forward as well in the field and try to position himself in a standing too, since he's still near the bottom of the cutoff. And other guys will win, especially if they're behind him. So he's got to try to win himself and solidify a position in the playoffs. So let's see if he can keep that up and see if he can do it. So it should be interesting to see what happens moving forward. So anyways, hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to leave a like if you are new, subscribe, brand new. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.